All right, guys, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to imagine a wheelbarrow, the ones with just the single wheel up front and the two grab handles in the back. Now, imagine you're holding up the wheelbarrow off the ground, and before we even begin to throw anything into the wheelbarrow, your job is to keep it as level to the ground as possible without letting the legs touch the ground. Now, I'm gonna start shoveling dirt and throwing it into the wheelbarrow. With every shovelful of dirt going into the wheelbarrow, guess what's happening? The weight from the dirt becomes increasingly heavier, and the more strength you'll need to keep the wheelbarrow level with the ground to offset or combat the additional forces from the weight. And that's pretty much exactly how an anti-sway bar works. Well, I mean, not exactly, precisely exactly, but the principle of this example gives a pretty good image of what we're about to go through with you guys. Also known as roll bars, anti-roll bars, stabilizers, or sway bars, an anti-sway bar reduces your vehicle's body roll and sway. Anti-sway bars are an important component of a vehicle's suspension, and not every vehicle has a sway bar, but they can be extremely useful, especially for lifted four-wheel drive vehicles. Like my wheelbarrow example, the more your vehicle is forced to turn throughout a curve or a corner, the more the gravitational forces are going to shift towards the side of the vehicle on the outside of the corner, and the more the anti-sway bar is going to have to work to counteract those forces to keep the vehicle as level as possible, just like when you were holding up the wheelbarrow as more weight was thrown into it. Some of you out there watching this right now who don't run any sway bars on your off-road vehicle, well, you guys know exactly what I'm talking about. Simply put, a sway bar is a torsional spring that connects to both the left and right sides of the suspension to reduce body roll. When both wheels take a bump equally, the wheels move the same amount without twisting the anti-roll bar. Individual wheel movement or body roll will force the bar to twist as the lever arms are moved, thereby adding the bar's own spring rate to that of the vehicle's springs. Although an anti-roll bar's main function is to reduce body roll in cornering, it also influences your vehicle's overall handling more than you would think. And one major vehicle performance limitation that a lot of us, we either forget to think about, or maybe we're just not even aware of it, is the overloading of our 4x4s with too much weight, more than the vehicle is even designed to handle. And then on top of that, we increase the center of gravity by lifting our vehicles, and in return, decrease the stability of our 4x4s, especially when it's windy or when we're off-roading in situations where we might be side-hilling and off-camber. When we start adding more weight on or in the vehicle itself, especially with a lifted vehicle, the harder the sway bar has to work when cornering or off-roading. If we add more weight than what the threshold capacity of the anti-sway bar is, the higher the chances are that the vehicle may roll over. This is where it's important to know your vehicle's gross weight capacity rating and to not only make sure you're staying within those weight carrying capacities, but also to make sure you're not loading too much weight too high up on the vehicle either. This is where it makes the most sense to try and keep as much cargo weight as possible as low on your vehicle as possible. Because as much as we'd love to upgrade our anti-sway bars to something stronger and more beefier and will keep your vehicle more stable while carrying extra weight, the truth of the matter is that if we end up going that route, then we end up sacrificing the suspension's capabilities by limiting the amount of articulation we often need when off-roading. The stiffer the sway bar is, the more it'll reduce the full extension of our suspension and the pressure of the tire contacting the ground when the opposing tire is trying to climb up an obstacle. And this is exactly why many avid off-road enthusiasts will purchase quick disconnects like the ones from JKS Manufacturing, or why several automotive brands will include an option for an electronically controlled disconnecting sway bar or a hydraulically controlled sway bar disconnect like on the new Ford horses. Broncos, horse Broncos, Broncos. Anyways, anti-sway bars work great for on-road handling, but handicap our vehicle's off-road performance by not allowing the suspension to work at its maximum articulation potential. Besides having factory sway bar disconnects or the JKS quick disconnects, there are also the off-road friendly anti-sway bars that provide a balanced performance of the front and rear suspension for rugged off-road conditions, as well as a balanced on-road handling feel. They distribute the weight and traction over all four tires. The one from Rock Jock 4x4, the Anti-Rock Sway Bar, is an excellent example. So to sum it all up, to maintain your vehicle's on-road performance handling while cornering, try not to overload your vehicle with too much weight or pack it up too high up on your vehicle, and to really optimize the full potential of your vehicle's off-road performance, check into the JKS Quick Disconnects or the Rock Jock Anti-Rock Sway Bar kits if your vehicle isn't already equipped with a factory sway bar disconnect option. And guys, definitely make sure and let us know if you guys have upgraded your sway bars or removed them or have done any other modification to them in order to try and get the best of both the on-road and off-road performance aspects of them. Definitely make sure and let us know in the comments below. Also, keep in mind that we do offer free mounting, free balancing, and free shipping to any state in the lower 48 on all of our wheel and tire packages, and all can be found right on our website at Trobelt Off-Road. And guys, as always, we appreciate all of you for watching and all of your support. I'm Josh from Trobelt, and we'll see you guys out on the trails.